Hi, I've decided to start a new series. So every Monday, look for this particular podcast. And check out my daily book reviews every day of the week, usually at least one a day. That's what I aim for. Sometimes I get two or three in. There are no special effects here. There's no drop-ins. I have no theme music. There's no anything. It's just me reading books, simple. I also review Star Trek Next Generation on Fridays, and we are getting into the end of Season 3, beginning of Season 4 Borg territory. So that's going to be exciting, so please check that out every single Friday. And if you haven't seen those Star Trek Next Generation videos, please go check them out. Also, I do the book reviews every day, at least one, sometimes two or three, depending how fast I read the book or how much I get into it. I'm also doing a nightly Boggle session about 6:45 Eastern Standard Time. We play 1 3-minute game of Boggle. The most unique words wins. That means if you find words that I don't find, then you get a point for every word that you found that I didn't find. And then you get a shout out in the next video. However, no one has played thus far, over 8-9 games now. So it would be nice if someone would join me to play some, just 1 3-minute Boggle. The whole thing takes about 6 minutes tops, not even that much. So please check that out every night. So like I said, this is Monday. Oh, welcome to the D. Louise Book Series. I'm Christina K.R.I.S. T.I.N.A. And this is where I read a book and review it and talk about a book. Sometimes I get really enthusiastic about some of my authors and I'll actually read the book. So anyway, this is going to be Flashback Monday. We're going to do this every single Monday as I can. I have about 10 years worth of magazines, maybe a little bit more. So maybe this will last a year or so or longer, depending on how it goes. But way back when, there used to be this magazine called Book Reviews. And they used to do over 200 plus books a month. You know, the ones nowadays don't even come close. Maybe there's 20. I don't even think there's 20 in some of the ones. And some of them are really, really expensive. Some of them, like, one of the book review ones is like $500 for a subscription. This was like $10. They did 200. And not only did they do 200, but they did books that I read, that the average normal person reads. So let's get started. So, check these out if you haven't seen them. Kelsey Kroll, If You Dare, If You Desire, If You Deceive. I have those. Fierce Scottish brothers shadowed by a dark curse face steamy new adventures in Kelsey Crowe's thrilling trilogy. He tried to run. In his youth, Hugh McCarrick foolishly fell in love with a beautiful English lass who delighted in teasing him with flirtatious ways. Yet he knew he could never marry her because he was shadowed by a cursed family legacy. If You Dare, Jane Whalen was devastated when the Highlanders she believed would marry her abandoned her instead. Years later, when Hugh McCarrick is summoned to protect her from her father's enemies, her heart has turned to fury. If You Deceive, in hiding, Jane torments Hugh with seductive play. He struggles to resist her because of deadly secrets that can endanger her future. Beatrice Small, The Twilight Lord. Now, we've done some of hers. I've done some podcasts on hers. But we will go back and do each book individually. But The Twilight Lord is part of a series. And I've got these all, and we will do these eventually. But this came out that month. Lara Domina of Terra has mysteriously disappeared while visiting the New Outlands. The Dominus is frantic to find his beloved wife when no trace of her can be discovered. Mangus Hawk turns to two strong allies, Prince Caelig of the Shadows and his mother-in-law, Ilona, the most powerful of the fierce fairies. Who has stolen Lara and why? In the Dark Lands Koi, the Twilight Lord reveals his victory. The fairy woman Lara is now his possession, and her powers will soon help him to conquer first Hector and then Terra. But the Emperor of Hector is hatching shames of his own, having learned of Lara's disappearance. He believes Terra is now vulnerable and plans to go to war against Magnus Hawk. And let's see. I just love this magazine. This was the best magazine in the world. Hundreds and hundreds of books. Oh. So, here I have circled Chris Marine Green. I bought it, but then I ended up giving it away because I didn't like it. Very far ahead, I have a Bible's worth of mythology for Vampire Underground that's explored in Night Rising. There will be no shortage of material, believe me, since I don't know how long the series will ultimately last. So it does that. Then the other one that I have circled over here, Succubus Blues, I still have, because it was a really good series. When it comes to jobs in hell, being a succubus seems pretty glamorous. A girl can be anything she wants. The wardrobe is killer, and mortal men would do anything just for a touch. Granted, they often pay with their souls, but why get technical? But Seattle succubus Georgina Kincaid's life is far less exotic. Her boss is middle management demon with a thing for John Cusack movies. Her immortal best friends haven't stopped teasing her about the time she shapeshifted into a demon goddess getup complete with whip and wings, and she can't have a decent date without sucking away part of the guy's life. At least there's her day job at a local bookstore, free books, all the white chocolate mocha she can drink, and easy access to best-selling sexy writer Seth Morrison, a.k.a. whom she would give anything to touch but can't. Sounds good. Also circled on this page down here is... what do I do with it? Oh, here it is. Karen Chance, claimed by Shadow. A recent legacy made Cassandra Palmer heir to title Pythia, the world's chief clairvoyant. It's a position that usually comes with years of training, but Cassie's circumstances are a little unusual, and now she's stuck with a whopping amount of power that every vamp, fae, and mage in town wants to either monopolize or eradicate. And then she herself doesn't dare use. What's more, she's just discovered that a certain arrogant master vampire has put a geese on her, a magical claim that warns off any would-be suitors and might explain the rather intense attraction between them. But Cassie's had it with being jerked around, and anyone who tries it from now on is going to find out that she makes a very bad enemy. And I've got them. I've got the whole series. So it was a good series. So we'll do that too. Jennifer Almentrout, The Possession. Let's see. Where is it reviewed? I come from a family that seems to believe in quite a bit, but not talk about it. I grew up with my maternal grandparents. Oh, this is her personal. All right, so we won't do that. But Gemma Amerson, The Possession, Book 2 in the Blood Tie series. My father always said fear was weakness. Well, that's easy to say when you don't have to worry about vampire slayers or holy water. I hate fear, but undead life goes on. In the 2 months since I was attacked in the hospital morgue, and since I turned into a vampire, I've killed my evil sire, Cyrus, fallen in love with my new sire, Nathan, and have even gotten used to drinking blood. Just when things are finally returning to normal as they can be, when sunlight can kill you, Nathan becomes possessed, and then he slaughters an innocent human. Now it's my job to find Nathan before voluntary vampire extinction movement does, because they're just waiting for an excuse to terminate him. And if anyone foolish enough to help him, but it gets worse. It turns out that Nathan's been personally possessed by one of the most powerful and wicked vampires alive, the Soul Eater. So, if I've kept it all these years, it must be good. And we will do the series eventually. So, Kitty Takes a Holiday. After getting caught turning wolf on national television, Kitty retreats to a mountain cabin to recover and rewrite her memoirs. But this Kitty is so troubled, is never far behind. And instead of Walden Pond, she gets Evil Dead. First, someone leaves grotesque and animal sacrifices on her front porch to curse her. Then werewolf hunter Cormac shows up with an injured Ben O'Farrell, Kitty's lawyer, slung over his shoulder. Two hotties and one kitty in a single cabin. Can the situation get even more tense? Lots of romance. Jim Butcher. The books are really good, but if you've done the audiobooks, James Marsters, I think that's how you say it, the guy from, he played Spike on Buffy the Vampire Slayer. He reads in one tone like this, and even when there's a battle, he still reads like this. I just couldn't. I had books first. The audio is just, ugh. So, it is hot today. Like, 80 something. Is it warm where you are today? Oh, I did the Tanya Huff series a while back. The Vampire, the Blood Ties series. They reviewed it. The Fantastic Primetime. This was a good series. Check out my video on that. And I'm still looking, by the way, if anybody ever finds a vampire detective, let me know. Check out my Tanya Huff and my requirements. They don't exist. No one is writing those books. I don't want no cure vampire or anything like that. I want a vampire and someone else working to solve mysteries each book. Like these guys did in Tanya Huff's series. There's four or five books in that series, a real small one, but it was awesome. And this primetime show would have lasted a hell of a lot longer if they didn't put it on at 1 o'clock in the morning. Oh, I have this one too. I just didn't pick it out to show. Notorious by Virginia Henley. Henley's at the top of her form, balancing history and passion to perfection. Using the tremulous reign of Edward II as backdrop, she gives us a heated romance and a hero and heroine who are an integral part of the historical events. Verena D. Beauchamp. Isn't that Claire's Outlanders? The daughter of Joey D. Beauchamp and the Earl of Warwick is a stunning beauty whose curiosity about the court is piqued when Roger Mortimer and his son Wolf visit her home. Though betrothed to Lincoln Robert D. Warren, Brianna is attracted to the virile wolf. She tries to resist the attraction, but he employs his Celtic gift a second to woo her. Sorry. If you desire an assassin for the crown, Hugh McCarrick is used to danger. With a curse over his head, he can be reckless, since he believes he has nothing to lose. But when his superior requests Hugh guard his daughter, Jane Whalen, he was in danger of losing his heart. I have these two, but they're up. Joanna Lindsay, Captive of My Desires, and The Devil Who Tamed Her. Please check out my earlier video on the Joanna Lindsay Mallory series. Mallory's versus the Briggertons. Beatrice Small. The Twilight Lord. I did this one right. Laura Domini of Terra. Yeah. Shoot, now I left the place. But every Monday we'll be doing these flashbacks. Oh, I do have this one too. The Demon You Know by Christine Warren. The books are alphabetical. Well, not alphabetical by author, not by title. Then they go by series 1, 2, 3, 4. So, oh, there's the Notorious. And this is the rest of the series. See, I'm a series person. I read series books. That's what I do. I don't like to read standalones. I like to read and get to know the characters. I like to watch the character progression from book to book to book. Oh, we did that. We did the Lindsays. The Twilight Lord got 4.5 stars. Lara, the wife of Magnus, used to recognize her destiny is yet to be fulfilled when she hears rumors of war between her homeland, Hetar, and the land she rules. And Amanda Quick. I don't have this one, I don't think. The River Knows. That got 4.5 stars. Hannah Howell. I have these two. You have to check these out. Highland Barbarian, Highland Wolf, Highland Savage. And now we've been doing the Arginos. And I try and do at least one or two a week for the Arginos, for Lindsay Sands' Argino. But she also writes historicals. Funny and Sweet to Darkly Seduction. All the Knights Heard Tales of Laurie Marie, King Edward III, Goddaughter, and Fetid Favorite. It was said she was stunningly beautiful with bright blue eyes, golden hair, and a sweet smile. It was also said that the king had doted on the girl and spoiled her rotten. Despite his need, when Sir Balan saw her howling and sobbing, Marie was the last person he wanted to wed. The brat. But all that glitters is not gold, and sometimes diamonds look very, very rough. There was more to Marie than meet the eye, and Balan soon learned that he would be lucky indeed to deserve such a bride. Tempting the Prince, Patricia Grasso. Wild Sweet Love, Beverly Jenkins. Klondike Doctor, Kate Bridges. My Lady's Treasure, Catherine Keane. The Vagabond Duchess, Claire Thornton. Lord Sin by Kaylin Hughes. I bought it but didn't keep it. The Duke's Indiscretion, Adele Ashworth. Colin Ramsay, the Duke of Newark, is infatuated with the opera singer Lottie English and will do whatever it takes to spend a night with her. He doesn't realize she's actually Lady Charlotte Hughes, the quiet sister of the man he's been asked to investigate. Charlotte adores her double role and dreams of making a grand tour, though she knows her domineering brother would rather have her married than on stage. Then they do mainstream fiction in the blue. And they do Louise Bagshaw Sparkles, Jennifer Bell The Stalker, Jonathan Benton Frank The Land of Mango Sets, Sharon Holmes, Dirty Game, Luann Jones, The Southern Comforts, Leslie Kagan, The Whistling in the Dark. Then they do inspirationals. Tracy Bateman, Defiant Heart, Kristen Billerbeck, Split Ends, Wanda E. Brustetter. She's still around. I'm pretty sure her books still come through the shop. A Sister Secret, Laurie Copeland, Simply Gifts. There you go. Some of those. Science Fiction's Fantasy. The Last Colony by John Scalza. Logoria by John Kilmer. Mother of Lies, Dave Duncan. Tony Ballantyne, Divergence, In War Times, Kathleen E. Bunnan only got 2 stars. The Silver Sword, David Zindel, got 4.5 stars. The Well of Shades, Juliet Marlier, got 4 stars. Then we do Romantic Suspense. Blood Right, Melanie Atkins. Object of His Affection, T.L. Gray. Janita Lowe, Virtually His. The Arrangement, Suzanne Forrester. Intimate Deceptions, Lise Fuller. Cindy Freiberg, Tainted Hearts. Here to Stay, Jennifer Matthews. Then we have Mysteries and Thrillers. And I can't see, like, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the, see, like that. There you go. Wendy Scorsese Staub, Don't Scream. Lee Child, Bad Luck and Trouble. Those, the Jack Reachers, they still come through the shop. Carol Nelson Douglas, those come through the, they're still, you can still get those. In the Damsel in Distress, Joan Hess. Tumbling Blocks, Arlene Fowler. Wuthering Heights, Dorothy Connell. Then we have Contemporary Romance. Robin Carr, Shelter Mountain. Kimberly Cates, The Wedding Dress. Beth Ciotta, All About Eve. Sharon Colors, The Object of Love. Janet Ivanovich, Hot Stuff. I got those over there. The Object of Love, 4 stars. Julie Ann Long, The Secret of Seduction. And He Loves Me, He Loves Me Not, Stephanie Rhode. They're over here. All right, Brenda Joyce. Dark Seduction, 4.5 stars. The Masters of Time. Malcolm of Dunrock is a newly chosen master. I know Vice 2's extraordinary and dangerous powers, but he has already broken his vows and a young woman's death is on his hands. Malcolm is determined to fight his darkest desires, denying himself all pleasure until fate sends him another innocent. The beautiful bookseller, Claire Camden. Check it out. And Wicked Fantasy. Did I bring that one down? I brought his... Oh, there it is. Here we go. Nina Bangs did a silly... Vampire series. Wicked Fantasy. Goddess kicked butt when you took them off. Connell O'Rourke learned this hard way after killing an Irish deity's favorite in battle. His punishment, he's cursed to protect Kavanaugh descendants down to the last arrogant jerk. Now there's only one left, and Connell thirsts to claim his freedom after centuries of servitude. But who knew the remaining Kavanaugh would be so beautiful, so sensual, and such a vampire? Check it out. Would it get 4.5 stars and labeled a scorcher? That means it's hot. Christine Warren, The Demon You Know, that got 4.5 stars. Over there. Being in the wrong place at the wrong time puts Abby Baker in a paranormal mess when a not-so-evil fiend named Ludamus jumps into her body. Wool is a demon who police the fiends, and he's on the trail of a dangerous Ezekiel, who is searching for a spell that will destroy the world. Okay. Aaron McCarthy. Blood Ray. Got 4.5 stars labeled hot. That means it's got some good stuff. Vampire babies and politics generally are not a good mix, but McCarthy's newest Vegas vampire tale, they certainly are wacky. Let's see. Hooking up with a vampire has its risks, but getting pregnant usually isn't one of them. Tell that to Brittany Bell Dizzy, who finds herself in the family way with no father in sight. After their one night of passion, vampire Corbin Jean Michael Atlea disappears off the face of the earth, or at least off the Vegas Strip. Corbin is a vampire with a cause, secretly trying to find a cure for his condition. But when he finds out Brittany is pregnant with his child, Corbin can't keep his parental instincts from trumping his blood-sucking ones. Blood red. Wild Thing. Yeah, I've got that too. I got 4 stars. Immortals, The Calling, Jennifer Ashley. I didn't choose that one. It's over there. Lara Aiden, Kiss of Midnight. I did this one in the Breed series. So you have to check my video out on that. He watches her from afar across the crowded dance club, a sensual black-haired stranger who stirs Gabriel Maxwell's deepest fantasy, but nothing about his night or this man is what seems. For when Gabriel witnesses a murder outside the club, reality shifts into something dark and deadly. In the shattering instant, she is thrust into a realm she never knew existed, a realm where vampires stalk the shadows and a blood war is set to ignite. Night Lost, Linville. Gabriel Sharon has fallen into the hands of the fanatical religious order known as the Brethren. Though abandoned by his fellow kin, he remains honor-bound to protect their secrets from his interrogators. Blindsided, nailed to a cross, and sealed in a chapel cellar beneath a ruined chateau, Gabriel faces an eternity of suffering. Nicola Nick Jefferson has been traveling across Europe, looting churches of their precious artwork and fencing the treasures to make a living. At each destination, she liberates the captive vampire, hoping they'll provide her with information leading to the one artifact she desperately craves, the Golden Madonna. Nightlass. Got 4 stars. And Tate Hall, I have that somewhere. I know I've had it. The Dead Sexy, powerful witch Garnet Lacey thought she had buried the truth about what happened when 6 members of a Vatican parliamentary organization murdered the other 11 members of her coven. Besides arriving late, the only other reason Garrett wasn't killed was because she instinctively drew on a power of the goddess of Lilith. Possessing Garnet's body, Lilith made short work of the murderous Vatican agents, but Garnet and then her boyfriend, Vampire Parrish, had to get rid of the evidence. Intriguing. Got 4 stars. They also did Mark, but PC Cast. That's a young adult one. That was a good series. It's still out there. No Humans Involved. The Kelly Armstrong series. That's a huge series. I've got all those too. Got 4.5 stars. Celebrity medium and necromancer Jamie has agreed to be part of a TV special and with 2 other mediums to raise the spirit of Marilyn Monroe. She is also hoping for romantic time with the alpha werewolf Jeremy, who is flying out to be with her. But their burgeoning relationship must take a backseat when Jamie discovers something extremely disturbing during the shoot. She believes that the trapped ghosts of young children may have been murdered are touching her. But who killed them and for what? For Jamie, the bigger issue is, how can she free them with the ghostly help of former Dark Witch Eve and sorcerer lover Kristoff? Jamie and Jeremy try to unravel the secrets of dark and baffling case. Altogether Dead. Sookie Stackhouse. We will do that series. Got 5.5 stars. Although she agreed to help Sufiane, the vampire queen of Louisiana, telepathic waitress Suki is not looking forward to attending the vampire summit. Where is that? It's over there. We will do that series. We will do those. Just when you say it. There you go. Altogether Dead. Being surrounded by all varieties of undead, changeling, and preternatural beings has gotten to be nothing out of the ordinary for Louisiana cocktail waitress Sookie Stackhouse. Sookie. I don't know why. I've always done that. It's like with Harry Potter. I don't know. It's just something I do. Still, even she has her limits. Betrayed by her longtime vampire love, Suki must now not only deal with a possible new man in her life, the oh-so-handsome shapeshifter Quinn, but also contend with the long-planned vampire summit in Rhodes. The summit, which has attracted undead-powered players from all over the U.S., is sure to be a tense situation. The Vampire Queen of Louisiana is in a precarious position, her power base weakened by hurricane damage to New Orleans. Suki gets a new friend in this one, a new permanent friend. Have you seen the series? The books are better. Although Alexander Skarsgård is just, But good series. We will be doing this series. I gotta put these back. Thing with taking all these books off your bookshelves, you gotta put them back. We missed one. Oh, this wasn't one of the ones. We did Kitty Take the Holiday. Okay. So, then we got, they also did the Harlequins. Nobody does the Harlequins today. Yeah. Here we go. Here, let's just read them out to you, because no one does the Harlequins. The Marrying Kind by Judy Christenberry. The Texas Ranger by Jan Hudson. Daddy's Protector, Jacqueline Diamond. Ed Geller's Homecoming, Marianne Wilson. Beyond Seduction, Kathleen O'Reilly. The Ex-Girlfriend's Club, Rhonda Nelson. The Man Tamer, Cindy Myers. All these got 4 stars. The Dark Gate, Pamela Palmer. Linda Howe, oh, she's still around. The Rain Tree Inferno. The Rain Tree Haunted. So, these are the books that were hot. Oh, they even did naughty. Lots of naughty books. I think the naughty section was bigger than the rest of the magazine. Oh, and what was it? In one of the, it was the Argynos, right? It was one of the Argynos where the main character went to a romance convention. Conventions. You could go and meet all your authors. So, stay tuned. Every Monday, we will be doing flashback to what was good to read. And we started with May 2007. So these are the books that will come brand new in 2007. God, can you believe Suki Stackhouse? But we will do this series soon. We will do the Beatrice Small series. So this is going to be every Monday. Check out the books that we were reading. Flashback Monday, we're going to call it. So please hit the like and subscribe. Let me know I'm doing a good job. There are no special effects here at all. It's just me reading books, talking books. That's it. Please check out my nightly Boggle game. 1 3-minute game and you're done. Star Trek Fridays. And my book review later today or early tomorrow. The Ann Perry. I'm starting an Ann Perry series. It's good so far. So check it out later. Please like and subscribe. Thank you.